reboot created a major problem. At the time, the show industry used a weighted boot in the show ring to help enhance our horse's natural gait. But the boot created a major problem, and if we wanted our horse to be compliant with the HPA, changes would have to be made. The Tennessee walking horse has a shorter pasture than most breeds, so the boot would rub and cause large calluses to form on our horse's foot in the front and sometimes around the sides. So we had to come up with a new action device that would have the same effect, but would be flexible while causing no harm to our horse. Many hours and days were spent looking for the perfect solution to our problem. Item after item was used till a simple lightweight chain was tried, and bingo, it worked great and caused absolutely no harm to our horse. You would have thought that would be the end of it, but you'd be wrong. Animal rights groups like the Humane Society of the United States, who attacked different animal breeds, had latched on to the Tennessee walking horse as one of their main fundraisers, and they were not about to let that happen. They immediately started making false statements about the size of the action device we used, and instead of showing the lightweight 6-ounce chain, they would use large log chains and claim that was what we showed him. Ugh. That's what they say we use. This is what we use. They would also use pictures from the 60s to show people and claim that was the damage done by the chain. However, as you can see, there is a major difference in the horse of today and the horse of the 60s. If people took the time to look at our horse and show industry, they would realize that the claims of widespread abusive training methods by people like the Humane Society and other groups is not their opinion. It is something they've made up using the past to describe the condition of our horse of today. Here's an example of the horse that made the HPA necessary, and here's the horse of today. As you can see, there is no comparison. To see how silly the claims are of the Humane Society of the United States, just look at what we as humans wear every day and never think anything about it. If we go in to buy a gold chain, the first thing we want to know is the weight. Knowing the heavier the chain, the higher the cost, but also wanting the value. We buy a watch, we don't consider the weight, we want the features and to see how it looks on our wrist. Look at the weight of the gold chain and you will see how silly believing a 6-ounce action device or chain would hurt a 1,000-pound horse. Look at the watch versus the man's weight. Once you do that, you will see that the Humane Society of the United States has used deceit to place members of Congress in unfavorable light, just as they use their lies to make suckers out of their donors. Members of Congress need to realize that those donations provided by the Humane Society have a price and is your integrity. I don't care to be made a fool of for any amount of money. And the Humane Society of the United States is great at getting the people to do just that. They paid a guy to lie under oath, so they are capable of anything, even making an accomplice out of members of Congress.